Hey, it's Lucy.
So it's a bit of a scary thought after 3 or 4 years, maybe longer, focused so single-mindedly on one project. What do you do after your PhD? First year of your PhD and you don't think about this stuff. You've just spent half a year, maybe a year, just trying to get on this course. And now that you're there, you're rightfully feeling very good about yourself. I'll call this the secure phase, where you've just achieved the great goal of getting on your PhD, and you're not really thinking much about what comes next at all yet. But it was something that was in the periphery of my head from maybe second year onwards. You started paying more attention to what people around you were saying about life as an academic, and some people hated it, some people were up for it, and I kind of figured, well, you know, it's what I'm training for, I'll probably do it. You know, I'll be a real scientist, I'll be principal investigator on the next Mars mission, I'll get a handful of postdocs, then get a professorship. But all the while, these thoughts seemed really distant. It was kind of like seeing a wall in the distance on the horizon and thinking, oh, well, it looks quite big, but I'm sure by the time I get there, I'll figure out how to get over it. Second year is the optimistic phase. It'll be fine. I don't need to think about it right now, but I will in the future. Then as the years and months grind by, as you're working very hard away, suddenly that wall doesn't seem so distant. By third year, this is the unsure phase. I was starting to think a little more seriously about things, but still in abstracts, as in, life as an academic seems strange. Everyone here works really hard and complains an awful lot and has terrible job security and moves around all the time and doesn't really get paid that well. But I love Mars and I get paid to study the universe, so I guess, sure, let's still do it. Then fourth year comes, and it's time to start committing to those words. And this is when the practicalities set in, and this is the panic phase. I don't want to move around all the time. I don't want to be dependent on short-term grants. I don't want to work every free hour just to stay competitive. With the prospect of unemployment rapidly looming and with the growing dread that I was more and more sure academia was really probably not the path for me, I started to look at jobs outside of the non-postdoc route with a kind of disbelieving sense of dread. What if I couldn't find anything I liked? What if I couldn't find anything I could do? What if I'd wasted 4 years of my life getting overly qualified in a useless subject like the geology of Mars, while my friends and my two amazing younger sisters had risen high in their careers out of sheer skill and experience? It was then that I discovered something very interesting and very unexpected. While looking for the skills required for jobs quite out of my subject area, quite out of my comfort zone, I discovered that it wasn't just a PhD in Martian geology that I'd nearly got. The skills sections of these jobs were looking for lab experience, and experience with scientific instruments, and report writing, and presentation experience, and peer review experience. All things I had developed in my PhD. I was employable after all. And you will be too if you have put any effort at all into your time as being a student. I got excited looking at jobs then. I started to feel this could be a whole new change for me, a whole new industry. I started to think again that maybe this PhD thing wasn't such a bad idea after all. So fourth year really has two phases, and this is the excited phase, because this is your chance to go anywhere in the world, do any job, and do whatever you want. You may never have more freedom in your whole career than at this point, so make it count. Looking back with all the joy of hindsight on my attitude to jobs during my PhD, there's one clear thing I would do differently, and that is constantly bear in mind, is this making me employable? I always just assumed I would be an academic, but you only need to look at the sheer volume of people who are doing PhDs these days compared to the number of advertised postdocs and professorships to see not everyone can be, or like me will even want to be. So play it safe and assume you won't be, and think to yourself, hedge your bets outside of your highly specific subject area of tagging stingrays or building a cat-human translator. What transferable, employable skills are you gaining in all this? I recreated Martian lakes in my PhD, but I did this in a lab, and I learned how to use a lot of analytical instruments. If I had mapped Martian lakes like I did for my master's, that's spatial information, that's statistical analyses, that's town planning. I know right now you might think that academia is all you'll ever want, and hey, maybe you're right. But just in case, bear this in mind. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, there are links in the box thing below about the next stage, which is the job interview, and there's also a video on the discussion to the precursor to this, which is staying or leaving academia. And please do subscribe to follow what happens next in the PhD journey. My name is Lucy Kizik. I'm a PhD student at the University of Oxford and a chemist in the nuclear industry, and take care.